We're here today to announce charges in the largest college admissions scam ever prosecuted by the Department of Justice.
When the FBI went public with Operation Varsity Blues and exposed a network of wealthy families caught cheating on college admissions, prosecutors confirmed what most people already guessed, that when it comes to getting into the best schools, there's one system for people who have money and one for everyone else. Yale was one of the schools implicated, and the news broke as their students were out on spring break. Vice News caught up with a group of wealthier students in D.C. and sat down with a group of lower-income students who stayed on Yale's campus in New Haven.
So what did you think when the news broke about this cheating scandal?
Comical.
Yeah. It's probably the funniest thing that's happened this year, but the like gravity of it is something that I haven't seen almost ever.
I think at first I was very like, oh, I'm so unsurprised. And then the next day I was like, no, I'm actually really angry. I think the anger took a while because it was so funny.
It's been a strange experience because the news broke when we started spring break. So you go from being completely immersed in Yale and the culture and your friends and then being back at home and then hearing about your school through like the lens of a news outlet or something else.
I think everyone's kind of aware that there are people pulling some shenanigans to get in. And I guess the only newsworthy part about this is it's particularly outrageous, but it's not categorically different than a lot of the so-called legal ways that people game the system. So,
have any of you benefited from legacy status?
I have. Yeah, my sister went to Yale.
Yeah, I'm a legacy, so.
Do you ever feel as legacies that either other people think you don't deserve to be at Yale or you even find yourself internally wondering if you really deserve your spot?
I've not personally felt that. Though, honestly, if people treat you worse because you got a massive advantage to get in, I'm also totally fine with that.
I think we've all been in a class or two where we realize someone's just not up to par and you start having questions about what's going on.
Oh boy.
And then, you know, you start figuring things out, like they're extremely wealthy, they went to great prep schools, their parents, a lot of those, just my very small sliver of experience are legacy students, which we have a high number of. They have much higher chance of getting in than a regular student.
I did look into my own application and found that like there were references to me being a legacy, but they also referenced that I had legacy at other colleges. Like I theoretically had like four relatives who went to Princeton and I was waitlisted and rejected.
When you do talk to wealthier friends or classmates, what do they say about this whole system?
I think everyone acknowledges that it's like kind of fucked up. Like I don't think anyone thinks that this is okay, but they're okay because it's benefiting them.
I get a lot of friends that will then go, yes, my experience, but look at that person that owns this or that or like is wealthier than me. Because we have people who are like middle class or upper middle class, but then we have people who are like the top, like the 1%, those people, is a lot of pointing towards them.
Do you think that there's a moral difference between photoshopping your kid onto a sports team or bribing a soccer coach and buying a building ahead of your kid applying to school?
I think there is a moral difference between like perhaps donations versus bribery, just because you can give a donation to the school and the school benefits. It might pay for other kids' tuition, it might pay for like new programs or something that can benefit people. Bribery doesn't go to the school. I think donations have a benefit.
Like at the end of the day, there's no, the reason why these students got in, whether it was buying a building or photoshopping your face onto a water polo team, was because of money.
Right.
Neither one of them got in because of their merit.
I see no difference. You're still bribing your way in.
Do you see a difference? Like a moral difference between paying someone to take your SAT and ACT or paying like many, many thousands more to have like a private tutor?
There's probably a difference, maybe a difference in degree, if not in kind. But in terms of, is this meritocratic and is this fair? Did you quote unquote deserve to get in? I don't see a huge difference. Both of them are unfair to people who don't have those resources.
And it's also frustrating, like, I'm sure we've all gotten the, like in high school, like, oh, you got in because you're XYZ, like, affirmative action, isn't that so great? And then never talking about, like, affirmative action for the rich, which is just, like, such a real thing.
How does wealth affect campus life here?
Like, it's like when we're not doing campus activities that I feel the wealth gap, like being here during spring break is always a time when I'm kind of like, oh, I like, all people are good at hiding their wealth, I think, until they're not. And so spring break is an interesting time when you just like go on Instagram and you're like, oh, you're like in this private island. I see a butler in the background of this photo. Like, oh, cool.
I write pretty extensively for the newspaper. And it's kind of this like all engrossing activity that takes up a lot of time. And because of that, it really prohibits some of the students who have to work like the multiple campus jobs, multiple hours a week. And so as a result, like pretty much all of my editors, like the other reporters are like aggressively wealthy.
Everyone tries to appear middle class.
Yeah.
So the lower class people are trying to appear middle class, so they'll like try to access wealth in whatever ways they can. And then the higher class people are trying to appear middle class too, so they'll hide certain things. But I don't know if anyone's actually good at it. Like, I definitely have felt difference in class from the day I stepped foot on campus.
Like, I think I know people are wealthy, but then it's like the extent of their wealth when you like look up how much their house costs on Zillow. And you're just like, oh, that's like your house costs more than my whole family has ever collectively had, like our entire like existence.
Has being at Yale changed your understanding of your class position at all?
Yeah, my high school was a lot more homogenous than Yale. And it was definitely way more people from just like the top 1% of society. I hadn't really been exposed to anything else before I went to Yale.
The high school I went to, I was on the lower end of like the income contribution. And in that sense, I kind of never saw myself as part of a particularly affluent group at my high school. But then coming to Yale and being exposed to like a much broader range of incomes and backgrounds, my understanding of what means are and what resources are and what agency is has changed quite a lot.
Yale has made me not understand my own class position, because I think I like went into Yale being like, I'm like middle class, and then I came to Yale and I'm like, oh my God, I'm broke. And like now I'm leaving Yale and I'm like, I'm somewhere in between those two. But I think it is like so easy to feel a lot poorer at Yale than you actually are.
So now that you're gonna graduate and go on to be legacies of Yale, do you see yourselves in a position where you have kids someday who want to come to Yale, you might flex the power, the influence you may end up with?
I couldn't imagine myself doing that. I don't feel any ties to Yale that they need to come here in any way.
I don't want anybody's folder to be with that little star that says legacy. Like, I would be completely fine if that got taken off.
So what do you think this entire story says about the state of our country and the college admissions system?
It ain't meritocratic. I think it suggests that we should be more cognizant about where we're drawing our talent pool from, because just because it says Yale on your degree, how much does that mean? I don't know. Maybe less than you think.